Hello friends, I'm Abhishek Kumar Singh. We are happy to announce that we are going to start a lecture series on internal combustion engine. Let me tell about something about internal combustion engine. It's the most important subject of the mechanical engineering. Many of the questions are being asked in the interview regarding the internal combustion engine, and many of the students are unable to give a simple answer. So we have thought that we should start a lecture series on internal combustion engine, and this would be the first lecture of IC engine. Hope you will like it. So let's get started. This will be the intro part. We'll be dealing some specs of IC engine, the starting part. So let's get started. So before starting internal combustion engine, let me first draw the layout of the automobile engine. You should know where the engine is located in an automobile. So first I will be drawing the anatomy of an automobile. So here is an anatomy of a two-wheel drive. So this is the wheel. This is the four wheels of an automobile. You have the engine here. This is your clutch. This is your gearbox. This is your propeller shaft. It will be till there. This is your differential, and the power goes to the wheel. So this is actually a two-wheel drive, and there is one more configuration known as four-wheel drive. So let me draw first four-wheel drive, then I will explain the difference between two-wheel and four-wheel drive. Same thing, four wheels are there. You have the engine. See, this is the four-wheel drive. So now we will be explaining the difference between two-wheel drive and four-wheel drive. See, in two-wheel drive, what happens is the engine generates the power. It goes to the clutch. This is the clutch. This is the gearbox. This is the propeller shaft, and this is the differential. I will be uploading a separate lecture on each of the part: the clutch, the gearbox, the shaft, the differential. So you do not need to worry what are these parts. On the subsequent lecture, I will be uploading the videos for every part. But first of all, you should know the layout. Where is the engine located? Because we are going to study internal combustion engine. So this is the engine part in which we are going to focus. What happens in two-wheel drive? The engine generates power. This power is transferred to the propeller shaft through the differential. It goes to the wheel. These front two wheels are free to rotate. That means they are not getting any power. The power is given to two wheels of the last. That is, the rear wheel gets power, and the front wheel is totally free to rotate. But what happens in four wheel drive is that both the wheel gets power from the engine. There one addition part is there, that the transfer case has been added to the four wheel drive. The transfer case does is that it transmits power to the rear wheel also, and it transmits power to the front wheel also. So what happens is there are two differentials. You get the power from the engine to the transfer shaft. The transfer shaft delivers power to back differential and the front differential, and from the differential we get power to the four wheels. These are the difference between two wheel drive and four wheel drive. And there is one more wheel drive, that is called AWD, all wheel drive. In the next lecture I will be uploading the all wheel drive also. So you need not to worry, just have a look. Just my motto to draw this wheel drive is that you should know where the engine is located, because I am teaching internal combustion engine. In the next lecture also we'll be dealing about various aspects where these are located, and I'll be making a separate video on this. So let's get started about engine. So since we are studying internal combustion engine, so first we should know what is an engine. Without the meaning of an engine, you cannot understand internal combustion engine. So what is engine? Engine is a device which converts one form of energy to another. Means any form of energy that can be converted into another form is called engine. So for example, engine means one form to another form. What is heat engine? Heat engine is a device that converts the chemical energy of the fuel into a mechanical energy. And this is the process that happens in an internal combustion engine. The chemical energy that is generated from the fuel is converted into a mechanical energy that pushes the piston and we get the useful work. So this is the standard definition of a heat engine. I hope that you got the meaning. What is a heat engine? Heat engine, engine is a device that converts one form to other form. Heat engine is a device that converts the chemical energy of a fuel into a mechanical work. So now heat engine is divided into two categories. The internal combustion engine, the external combustion engine. We are going to study this part, the internal combustion and the external combustion we are not going to study. Our mainly focus will be on the internal combustion engine. But you should know the difference between internal combustion engine and external combustion engine. Internal combustion engine is an engine in which the combustion takes place inside the cylinder, whereas in EC, that is external combustion, the combustion takes place outside the cylinder. So let me explain you by giving an example. In a power plant, what do we get is there is a fire and there is a fire going inside the down of the boiler. Steam is generated, steam goes through various heat exchanger and finally does a work in turbine. So this is an example of a EC because combustion is taking place at different part and you are getting a work at different part. But what happens in internal combustion engine is that you get the firing takes place at the same place and you get the work done at the same place. That means inside the cylinder only the firing takes place and the pressure generated pushes the piston down. For example, I will draw the diagram. This is the cylinder and this is the piston. The firing takes place here and the enormous pressure generates the work done that pushes the piston down. But what happens in external combustion engine is that you have a boiler here, the fire goes here, the steam is generated here, it goes through the pipeline and there is on your turbine and it heated and it runs and that generates the work done. See, the difference is that the combustion takes place inside the cylinder and pushes the piston down. The work done is done at the same place. Whereas in case of the external engine, your combustion is taking place here and you are getting work done here. So this is the main difference between the internal combustion engine and external combustion. Obviously, there are various advantages and disadvantages of each. So let me tell you some 2-3 advantages of internal combustion engine over external combustion engine. See, in internal combustion engine, what happens is that you get the firing takes place at the same place and the work done is at the same place. So efficiency is increased. But what happens in this case, you are generating a steam here. You are generating a steam here. It passes through a heat exchanger, then does the work. So efficiency is decreased. The main difference is that efficiency of a internal combustion engine is quite good as compared to the external. The second is that the weight to power ratio is less for the internal combustion engine. What do I mean by weight to power ratio? Means for a small weight you can get a large power from the internal combustion engine. Means an engine with a small weight can generate a power that is, for example, in scooter, a small engine can generate a huge power. So weight to power ratio is small, but in such engine the setup is more disastrous, very big setup, so you can't get more efficiency in these cases. And one more thing is that these are the advantages of IC engine, but obviously these also suffer at some disadvantage, like due to reciprocatory motion of the IC engine, vibration in case of internal combustion engine is more, because there, due to huge RPM, the RPM is almost 2500 to 3000, so a lot of vibration takes place due to reciprocating, piston reciprocates from up and down. This is the one of the most major disadvantage. Also, one more disadvantage of this internal combustion engine is that you can't use, means different type of fuel, like you can use only gaseous fuel and gaseous and liquid fuel, like you can use only petrol, diesel and also some research are going like biodiesel also, but basically constant kind of fuel you can use, like petrol, diesel, but in these cases you can burn anything just to produce heat. So I hope you get a clear view of what is internal combustion engine and what is external combustion engine, what is the difference between two, what is the advantage of IC over EC, what is the disadvantage of IC over EC. So let me first, let me again classify, sub-classify these two, so that you get a more clear picture what we are going to study. See, as I, in a systematic manner, I describe what is engine, from engine what I describe what is heat engine. The heat engine is divided into two categories, the IC and EC. Again, see, in internal combustion engine also you have two types, that is rotary and reciprocating. Rotary and reciprocating. Our main deal will be to deal with the reciprocating engine. Reciprocating engine can also be subdivided into two parts on basis of mechanical construction, one on basis of mechanical construction and other on basis of ignition. See, on basis of mechanical, it will be divided into two parts, that is 2-stroke and 4-stroke. 2-stroke, 4-stroke. And on basis of ignition, it is divided into petrol and diesel. Petrol is known as gasoline and diesel is known as compression ignition engine. So this will be petrol, that is called gasoline, and diesel, that is called compression ignition. It is also gasoline is also called spark ignition. So my main motto is that first of all you should know a picture, clear diagram about what we are going to study. Don't just randomly pick out, take out a petrol engine and start studying, because you should first have what is the category, how these are divided. There are also many categories of EC. Like in rotary also there are two parts. You have, they are like in this you have open cycle gas turbine, and you have one Wankel engine. But my main motive is not to study this. We will be focusing on these two part. These two part is the main, that on basis of which the engine runs. First one is your basis of mechanical construction, you get 4-stroke, 2-stroke. On basis of ignition, you get petrol and diesel. Your EC also is of two parts, reciprocating and rotary. Again, this is divided into two parts, your steam engine and one is your Stirling engine. This is also rotary, also divided into two parts. One is your closed cycle gas turbine and your one is your steam turbine. You don't need to worry about these parts, just leave it, but just focus on this part, because this will be the most important part in which I will be proceeding in this next lecture. So let me first revise it for you. I have discussed about the engine. First, before that, I have made a layout of two-wheel drive, four-wheel drive. From the diagram, at the end of the lecture, I will be providing with the clear picture at the end of the lecture, so that you can see the various locations of engine, clutch, differential. And one more thing, don't worry about the part that is differential clutch. I will be uploading a separate video regarding this. This is a lecture for beginner, so they should know first overview, then only they can know that function of differential. If now I will be telling you the function of differential clutch, then it will be a boring lecture. So first, in the subsequent lecture, as will be processing, I will be uploading the videos. So I think this makes a clear picture. I have discussed engine, heat engine, classification of internal and external. So what happens is, again I have told you the difference between internal engine and external combustion, the advantage of internal, over external. The disadvantage is that the reciprocating makes the vibration of the engine, and also that some constant fuel can be only used for this. I have subcategorized IC into rotary and reciprocating, but most important is reciprocating. Two types are sub classification on the basis of mechanical construction, on basis of ignition mechanical. On basis of mechanical you get 2-stroke, 4-stroke, and basis of ignition you will be getting petrol and diesel. So this comes, so from here I conclude these lectures. So please go through this, please do a revision, so that next time I will be uploading a video you will be quite clear with the concept. And please be regular on our channel Senior to Junior, so that we don't want you to miss any of the lectures. So please subscribe to the channel, so that when we will be uploading the video you will be getting a mail and you can watch the videos. So thanks for watching. I hope you like it and your comment will be appreciated. Any suggestion, please comment on the comment box. Share knowledge, share success. All the best. Thank you.